we dive now into the next few talks, and we begin with Hans Ries, who's the founder of Grameen Creative Labs from Germany. Hans, come on out. Let's give a round of applause for Hans.
Thank you. Hello. Can I have the click? Good. Good morning. Hello, friends. Joel. Thanks a lot to invite me to give a speech about social business. You know, that's what we should try to explain in the next 12 minutes. Can I have my slides, please? Is it on? Oh, no. Let's go back to this. Okay. You know, coming to the sports world, coming to one of the most extraordinary mindset in sports in our time, I was thinking to share with you my experience with one of the projects what I did 8 years ago. It was 100 women over 100 years. And we did ask the question, what is peace? Where is peace? How is peace and why is peace? And this woman, and I'm from Germany, this woman experienced the First World War, or was born in the First World War, was born in the Second, was living in the Second World War, overcome the Second World War. And to have a dialogue with the people around 100, it's very interesting, because they will be very honest to you, they're very smart, and they're lovely. And they're lovely like small children again. And if you talk about peace, we should use our opportunity to talk to them. And one of the main great lessons what I learned from these great ladies was in every culture of humanistic, the aim was peace. The last 4,000 years, 3,000 years since we become a civilization, our aim was to have peace. 200 years ago, there was a special moment, you know, when the French Revolution happened, when we had the farmer revolution in Germany, when we stand up and be a value-driven society and culture in Europe, when we had the freedom of every single person to be an entrepreneur. And it's only 200 years ago where we started to say, every one of you can be an entrepreneur. Every one of you have the license to do his own business. And at the same moment, very funny, 2 years later, the first sports club was founded. Who knows what was the first sports club in the world? It was in India, in Calcutta. It was a cricket. And then we had 100 years where we founded sports club all over the world. And sports become an individual movement. And then it was great French guys to say, peace, one of the highest aims of human race. It was already redefined it on a philosophical way with the Olympic Games, and they reinvented the Olympic Games. Similar like what you do today with peace and sports, simple way, how really honest you can be together. This was a very special moment for the human society and for the global society. And with these global societies, we got a lot of role models, not only in sports, but we got role models all over the world. We got it in social activists like Mother Teresa. We got it in scientists like Marie Curie, the only Peace Nobel Prize for a scientist. We got it with great artists. We got it with Einstein. We got it with entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs who have only one aim in the 19th century, how to overcome poverty. Then we had fallback with the Second World War. But directly after the Second World War, people start to think again, we have to have peace. We founded the United Nations, a major step for a globalized world. A dreamers after the Second World War to say, let's build a world in peace, in dignity, in human rights. And these dreamers, really, you have to imagine, just the Second World War was over, and then people come together and say, give Germany another chance. And I'm from Germany, I'm born 1966. I had nothing to do with all this, but believe me, 90% of my generation still feel very, very ashamed what happened. But you give us a chance to be part of the society, The most biggest chance was 1954 in Bern, when Germany won the first World Cup. It was the feeling you accepted again. And it was a second feeling in 2006 when we was able to host the World Cup. And you show us you accept it. You give us, my generation, who are born 60s, a chance to be part of your community. You give us the feeling we can be a part of a good civil society. And we achieved bold stuff in business, in sports, politics. And we achieved so many things in the last years, in the last decades. Unbelievable. Miracles. Imagine after 1,200 years between France and Germany, Mitterrand and Kohl makes a real shake hand about the whole stuff. Business get globalized. And it becomes another role model. That's what I want to share with you. A man from Bangladesh, very simple professor, had a great idea. An idea that business can be social conscience driven. Business, the most dominant institutions of our time, can be done to say, I make a business to solve a problem, to focus on the problem, but with a zero loss and a zero dividend. So he redesigned and shaped a business opportunity to say, oh, I can make business not only to be in a way to be selfish and to make business for myself, I can do business to help people to come out of the biggest misery. This man was awarded, Professor Yunus, with over 2,000 awards. He was awarded like only Martin Luther King, Norman Borlaug, Nelson Mandela, Elie Wiesel, or great Nelson Mandela. An economist brought peace into the world and bring peace into the world about the idea of social business. And remember, sports was coming out from the philosophic aspect to say, if we play and if we're gaming, we have peace. Because we are playful mind, we are joyful minds. Human nature is to have joy. Human nature is to share and to enjoy life, to play. Business is not an English term. Business is an Italian term, it's called business. It was invented in 600 years after Jesus Christ in a small village in northern of Italy to overcome the natural stress, to overcome the winter season. Business was done to share our responsibility, to say, you take care for the winter season about the food, you taking care about and every house is on fire and every house is heating up and you taking care nothing happens to us. So business was carefully together. This was the original meaning of business. It was not to making money. It was caring. It was sharing responsibilities and roles. Then, of course, the invisible hand, and you know the stories, the greedy aspect of business could take it over and say, business is only selfish, only if you make money. What's not a problem, make money so much as you want, but business is not only a single dimension. This is what Professor Yunus shows and the Grameen family in Bangladesh, to say, oh, there is a way how we can use the efficient, the management tools and the behavior of a good business in the social good. So they founded the Grameen Bank, taking care about the poorest of the poorest women, give trust, say everyone, every single person is an entrepreneur, is a goal-getter, you're humankind, you can achieve enormous great goals. Now when we look forwards the next 10 years and we look up to Los Angeles 2028, I hope peace and sports and Joel, in your many disciplines, we can help the original bold people with peace and sports to come back to the original roots. Peace and sports today is 10 years old. Sports is full of business. I think with your friends and with your achievement, you can really redesign the sports world. You are third player between the FIFA and the IOC, you know. You really can show what we all stand for when we do sports. We stand for to open doors. We stand for to see to the children and say, you are part of our society. And in a very simple way, every one of us can play, can be be part of our game, can be part of our ambitions. And sports business can be revolutionized with the idea of social business. How bold is today the sports business? Imagine we have only 5% of the sports business as a social business. Imagine we create desire brands, great sport brands out of the way to say we should open for every young girl in the world to do sports. Imagine in Kashmir, young woman going for snowboarding. Imagine everywhere in the world we have skating rooms for young girls and for young boys. We do it all because we love our children. We are the first time we are all in this room and in our history where we have the opportunity, to take care about every child. We will have 2 billion children today. In 16 years, we have 2 billion children. The big thing is with the right values, the right role models, with the right thinking about business and social conscience-driven business, we will be able by 2022, 2023 to take care about every born child. Not a single child have to die. And that's where we should have dreams. That's where we should come together to play, to use this possibility and take care about all of them. It doesn't care, is it my child, is it your child, is a child, and we have to take care. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, Hans. That was great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Dankeschön.
Bitte schön.
Great. Good day.